All right, let's go. Welcome to Skafos. This is where the magic happens. So normally when I come in, I kind of get situated and look through our Slack channel. That's where we do most of our team communication. So messages back and forth, and we have different channels for different topics. And so I normally check out the general channel to see if people are going to be late today or like what's going on, and if people are out, any events I need to know about. And then normally right after that, I launch right into sort of our ticket board. We use GitHub to both track our code, and we also use GitHub for managing our work that we're doing. So I see there's something that I started yesterday that I need to actually start testing, which is basically providing our system the ability to take some options as input, and I need to make sure that the code and the system is able to handle it. And so I wrote all the code yesterday to do it, but actually today I need to kick off some tests to make sure that it works. So I started at Skafos about 3 years ago, and actually our company had a different name at the time, and we were doing something totally different. But that's sort of the nature of a startup, is that we've sort of snaked around until we found exactly the target zone for us. And so we've been working with different customers in the online retail space, so e-tail is what it's often called, or e-commerce. You know, everyone is familiar with product recommendation engines from Amazon or from wherever, but you know, the middle market companies that aren't on Amazon or aren't trying to sell out to Amazon want to have a way to be able to give their shoppers, their customers, a great way to find products that they want and that they're looking for. So most of the modeling and data science work that I'm doing is taking feeds of data and trying to parse them, clean them up, and prepare them, and use different machine learning techniques, whether it's natural language processing, computer vision or image processing, or even various deep learning techniques on structured data to codify information about these products so that we can, again, understand the relationships between them. So when we're making recommendations and we're serving up things that we think customers might like, it comes from a place of knowledge that's derived from the data that we're working with. And so this pipeline is going out and grabbing data from some cloud location, in this case, Google Cloud as a data source. It's sort of pulling it, validating that data, and in this case, the model that I'm testing is a suite of product recommenders, and the first one is a product pairing model, which the idea is if you put an item in your cart, what are items in the full inventory of this particular e-commerce site that would go best with that item? And so our model is going to recommend a bunch of different products to pair with it. And fair warning, this pipeline will take a long time. And if you can see right here, I'm getting a red. So that means that one of my tasks failed. You know, they'd make it easy for me. They give me color, so I don't really have to introspect too much further. But now we do need to see what went wrong. I'm guessing it has to do with what I just did. So I try to go pretty deep here, you know, mega cup. We normally go through maybe 2 to 3 pots a day. It just depends on who's here. So I was able to figure out in the code what was wrong. It was a type issue. I had put in strings to fix one area where there was a bug. But in doing that, I actually did need it to be an integer, like downstream in the training code, and so I needed to reconvert it back to an integer when the training job reads it in. So you can see that job that was initially red is now green. It's a good sign. That means that at least on the test case that I gave it this morning, the feature that I was working on is done, you know, if I was really smart about this, I would do some unit testing. I might add a test to our test suite to make sure that nothing like this breaks again. And so, yeah. One of the things we typically do are whiteboard sessions where we'll have something that is an end goal we know we need to build, whether it's a particular feature or maybe it's a large chunk of work. But whatever it is, we know that there's some technical solution or some implementation detail that needs to be hashed out. And so we'll typically work together in that setting, and it often has yielded much faster development timelines when we have a whiteboard session before we actually start coding. So we take that pretty seriously here, and we always try to abide by that kind of policy. So this is the pineapple. And while it's a delicious fruit, it's actually very important fruit for our company, and here's why. Pineapple has always been a term at this company, basically to mean we're going down a rabbit hole that we don't need to be going down. So someone will say pineapple when they are basically saying table this discussion for some other time. And so sort of as a joke, someone brought, I think it was Caroline, brought one day a plush pineapple that in the mornings we use and throw at each other as like a talking piece. So like during our stand-up when we're all sharing what we're working on, someone will pass it to the next person, and you just pass it around until everyone's had their opportunity to share. And so that's become a morning ritual for us now. It started off kind of as a joke, and now it's like, okay, this is like actually sort of our process. Coming to work in the morning, I'm always excited to get up and get here. That's one of the things I love about this job, is that every single day is a different experience. Every day is different problems and different struggles. And I always feel like at the end of the day, I've A, accomplished something, and B, learned something. I can't name a single day where that hasn't happened. And I'm very thankful for the team and just this beautiful office and this beautiful location in Charlottesville that we have to grow and learn and explore in that way. So every day is a new journey. And while my literal commute is 30 seconds or less, I'm just really excited to be here and be sharing and learning from others.